Whitewashing is the process of covering a surface with a very thin coat of plaster, made with a basic mixture of water and lime. It's used to color fences, wood, and most commonly walls. Whitewashing has been done for centuries and is a fairly easy process. Today we're whitewashing a house that was last whitewashed about 5 years ago. You can see some quite bad staining in places that has been caused by water runoff. We'll start off by cleaning the entire house. This is most easily done by pressure washing the walls. Firstly, spray water onto the walls using a garden hose. Start at the top, and as the water flows down the wall, you can wet the rest of the wall. In this case, we can reach most of the house while we're standing on the ground. As the dirt on the walls becomes wet, it loosens its grip on the wall and will come off very easily when you use the pressure washer. If you try to pressure wash without soaking the wall, you'll struggle to get it clean. Leave the wall to soak for 15 to 20 minutes while you connect up the pressure washer. Now start at the top and pressure wash the wall. You'll notice that the dirt comes off quite easily, and it's even quite a fun job to do. You're going to get wet, so wear an overall or old clothes. Now if there are any sections that look a little green, showing algae or mildew infestations, spray a mixture of 50% household bleach, such as Jik or Clorox, and 50% water onto these places. You can buy household bleach at your local supermarket. The pressure washer will have removed the algae leaves, and now the bleach will kill the roots of the algae that are left in the wall. After 15 minutes, wash the bleach off the wall. Give it a good soaking to get all the bleach off the wall. Fill any cracks with painter's mate fitted into a cork gun. Do not use filler powder, as this is a hassle to mix in. It often shrinks as it dries and usually has to be primed before painting. The primer will take 24 hours to dry, so you'll just delay your work. Just slip a cartridge of crack filler into your gun, and you can easily fill medium-sized cracks using a paint scraper to smooth off the surface. You don't need to fill hairline cracks in the surface of the wall. The whitewash will fill and seal these little cracks. Often after pressure washing, the house is so clean and looks so good that you'll consider leaving the whitewashing for another time. Whitewash is made by mixing lime with water to form a paste. Other ingredients, such as salt, may be added depending on the whitewash recipe. We're using a ready-made whitewash, which is very cheap at 250 rand a bucket. That's about $25 per bucket. We used 6 buckets to do this entire house, a studio, and a small cottage on the side, so it goes a long way. First, spoon half of the mixture into a second empty bucket. Don't add any more water, just spread the liquid between the 2 buckets. The solids have sunk to the bottom, so using a stirrer, work the solids and the liquid together. After 4 or 5 minutes, the mixture will become more of a paste and is ready to be painted onto the wall. We're going to mix it really well, however, so put the whitewash in the second bucket back into the main bucket, mix them up, and then pour half into the second bucket again. And work both buckets to ensure that the whitewash reaches the right consistency. Now wet the wall that you're going to work on. You can use a whitewashing brush and flick it on, or a garden sprayer, or you can use a garden hose. The wall must be wet before you apply the whitewash. If it is dry, water will be drawn from the whitewash into the wall, and the whitewash may crack when it dries. Let excess water run off the wall, and after about 5 minutes, you're ready to begin. Apply the whitewash using a large whitewashing brush. You can apply it vertically or horizontally. We've used a technique of applying it with horizontal strokes to reduce any spillage, and then finished off vertically. The whitewash will retain the pattern of the final strokes, and we feel that dirt will wash off the wall when it rains more easily with a vertical finish. We've started at the top and work our way down. Often you'll have large sections of whitewash that came away from the wall when you did the pressure washing, and this may leave a step in the wall. You could sand the step, but you're giving yourself a lot of work and a dusty, horrible job. An easier way is to spot these edges. The whitewash is quite thick and the step will be covered. You can then whitewash the entire wall from corner to corner, and you won't notice the step. Whitewash is transparent when it's applied, but as it dries, it covers marks surprisingly well. If you find a spot that you want to cover again, just coat over that spot. The whitewash coats will blend together perfectly. It usually touch dries in about an hour, and dries completely in about 24 hours, depending on the weather conditions. It reacts chemically with the wall plaster as it dries and has the advantage of sealing surface cracks in a wall. Well, this job has taken 2 people 5 days, including the pressure washing, and it's cost us around 2,000 Rand, which is just under $200. It's tiring, but not at all difficult. If you're using the right product and the right techniques, you'll be able to do the job yourself and save yourself a bundle of cash.